Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn 5 ways to add insights to your report presentation slides. This video doesn't have a tutorial per se, but then the 5 things I'm about to discuss here are going to be extremely helpful to make your report presentations a lot more easy for your audience to understand than they are typically in a boardroom presentation. Now, I've seen a number of cases where people go to insert chart and then they typically pick up the first chart that they see in front of them and then they say okay, and they leave the audience to make sense of the various columns that they have on their chart. Now, here is something I want you to remember. There is a whole world of difference between a chart that is there in a report and a chart that is inserted on a slide. The 2 big differences are: when you insert a chart inside a report, you expect your audience to spend some time to make sense of the information. When you email a report to your audience, then they also have access to work with the numbers and then make sense of the chart by opening it in PowerPoint or by opening it in Excel, and then they can even massage the numbers to get even deeper insights. The situation is totally different when you have a chart on a slide. Your audience doesn't have as much time as they would typically have when they are going through a report. Second, they don't have access to tools to get further understanding of your numbers. So it is very important for you to make your charts extremely obvious for your audience. And one of the most important things that you need to keep in mind whenever you create a chart is you need to give context to the numbers. You should never present a set of data points like this and expect your audience to do the mental maths when you make your slide presentation. You should always try to make it easier for them to make sense of the data very quickly by providing relevant context. In this video, I'm going to show you some templates taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle that show you what kind of context that you can provide to make your data points much easier for them to make sense of. Our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle is a collection of more than 4,020 premium templates that take your presentation slides to a whole new level. The first example of providing some context is this one. As you can see here, when you have to present a set of data points like this, the least you can do is to add a little bit of context by showing which is the minimum value or which is the maximum value like this. Now, you can do that quite easily by using any of the callout options here in the auto shapes, or like this, when you use a template, then everything is automated for you. Now, in this case, as you can see here, the minimum value is 8, and that is in the month of August. Let us say the month of April has an even lower performance, let us say around 4, then the minimum value should shift from here to here automatically. Let us see how that is done. I'm going to right click on the chart and go to edit data, like the way that you would go to any normal chart. And let us say April instead of 24 is say 4, and I'm going to hit enter, and instantly that minimum value has moved here. Now this is done using conditional formatting. If you don't want to do any such thing, of course you can use any of the callouts from your auto shapes. But then the point here is, make it easy for your audience to make sense of your data points like this. The next example is this one. Here you see that we show chart with values less than median. As you can see here, the values are fairly large and your audience will find it extremely difficult to wrap their mind around these large numbers. So what I've done is I have added a simple conditional formatting so that the columns that are less than median value are shown with this tick mark here. Now, once again, as I told you, this is a data-driven chart, and let us right-click, go to edit data, and let us say a particular month, say in the month of August, you can see that the value is above the median value. And if it is lesser, say let us say it is only 90,000, then what happens? So let us go to August, and here I go to 90,000 and say enter, and immediately the value is lesser and it is indicated with a tick mark. So this is a very simple thing, but then it makes a lot of difference to make sense of these numbers. The next example is this one, where we visually represent performance before and after a key event. Let us say this is a scenario where the new management has taken over the company, and this is the performance after that event, and this is the performance before. As you can see here, it is very clearly obvious that the new management has been able to improve the performance quite significantly compared to the earlier one. So with just this simple visual representation of an event, you can very clearly see that this chart has become a story now. And as always, you can always change these values very easily using edit data option, and you can change the event by changing your numbers here. Now, the next example is to present your column chart with contextual bands like this. As you can see here, we have four performance bands which show poor, okay, good, and excellent performances. Without these bands, your audience doesn't really understand the actual meaning of each of these performances. With these bands, they can now put a label for each of these performances. And once again, this is totally data driven as well. A variation of this is this one, where the columns automatically change their colors according to the bands that you define. If it is less than 40, the columns automatically are in red color. If it is between 40 and 60, in green. And if it is more than 60, in purple color. And as I told you, this is totally data driven. If I want to change the value, say in this case, I's performance is really above 60. So I'm going to go to edit data, and I'm going to change this number to say, let's go to I, and let us say it is only 25, and I'm going to hit enter, and immediately it has changed into red because it is less than 40. And you can see that these kind of charts make it much easier for the audience to make sense of the information. A variation of this chart is a bar chart that shows the same information in different colored bands. Another variation of this is a control chart like this. As you can see here, this is the optimal performance zone or performance band. Now, the individual performances are shown using this line chart. Wherever the performance has been above or below the ideal range, then audience can immediately make sense of these individual data points. Of course, you can always define these bands all by yourself by just right-clicking and doing the edit data option. Now, this is another variation where you can see that the performance of two quarters are compared side to side for two different years. This one represents the earlier year, and this one is the current performance. And audience can now make sense of the individual performance a lot better because of this context. So as you can see here, just by adding some relevant context, you make your charts a lot more meaningful and insightful for your audience. It is essential for you to do this, especially because your audience doesn't have the time to do the mental maths for themselves. And of course, if you don't have the time to build such advanced charts yourself, you can always pick up the chart templates from our comprehensive all-in-one bundle and replace the sample data with your own data. All that and more is available in our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. This bundle is a collection of our best-selling PowerPoint templates packs, like our PowerPoint Charts and Diagrams CEO Pack 1, CEO Pack 2, which has graphics and concepts, Advanced Animations Pack, which has more than 750 cutting-edge animations that help you to tell a visual story, Visual PowerPoint Graphs Pack, which has data-driven PowerPoint graph templates like our dual thermometers, bullet charts, speedometers, visual pie charts, dashboards, etc. Flat Design Pack, which has modern flat design style PowerPoint templates. Hand-drawn Graphics Pack, which has slide templates that look very informal like this. Themed title templates that give a good first impression to your audience. And more than 400 new consulting models and frameworks that are not available anywhere else in any of the template sets in the market. If you're someone who's serious about making presentations that influence your career and business, then this is the best PowerPoint bundle you can invest in. And one more thing, as a thank you for watching this video this far, I am happy to offer you our free 5-day email course called 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas. Each of the ideas that I share in this practical email course is extremely easy for anyone to pick up and apply in the next presentation. You can sign up for the free email course by clicking on the link here. So please do click, and I will see you inside the email course.